Good morning children and welcome to all of you in online classes. Dear students, we are discussing the first chapter of Bistas book, or the name of chapter is the third label. This particular lesson, the third label, has been written by one of the well-known writers, or his name is Jack Finney, who was born in USA. Dear students, this well-known writer Jack Finney worked as a story writer, as a novelist, and I told you in previous video that the central character of this story third label is Mr. Charlie, or who has seen amazing things, who has experienced an amazing thing in his life, or that is the experience of third label. This particular character, Mr. Charlie, is telling about his experience of third label. How he reached, when he reached, or what he has seen on the third label of Grand Central Station. Or when he shared his opinion, when he told his experience to his psychiatrist friend Sam and his wife and others, they gave their reaction and they told that he wanted to escape from the harsh realities of life. Due to that, he is making such excuses. All these things we discussed in previous video. Dear students, today we will discuss line by line. Please open your book. Or here writer is asking, before starting the lesson, one question is given, ki have you ever had any curious experience? Any amazing experience which others find hard to believe, or that story whenever you tell to others they are not easily believing? If you have, so it will be easy for you to understand this lesson. Sometimes it happens ki the things which you have experienced, it is hard to believe that by the others, by other people, they don't believe easily. Understood? Because that thing is not experienced and seen by them, or that is not the normal thing which you have experienced. Now I am going to start the lesson line by line, dear students. Or this beginning portion is after visiting the third label by Mr. Charlie. Or he is very confident and sure that there is a third label on Grand Central Station. Though in reality there are only two labels, but the narrator of the story, Mr. Charlie, is very sure that there are another label, means the third label, on Grand Central Station. Or how he is telling, how he is sharing his experience. The president of the Newark Central and Newark and New Haven and Hartford Railroads will swear on a stack of timetables that there are only two. Or here the narrator is claiming, he claims that if anybody will ask to renowned personalities like the president of New Central and New York or New Haven or Hartford landlords, railroads, so they will take an oath. They will swear, they will take an oath. Or where they will take an oath? They will take oath on stack, on the heap of timetables or they of railway, and they will surely say ki these people will also say that there are only two labels at Grand Central Railway Station. But the writer wants to say that he has experienced a third label also. But I say there are three. These people, the president of Grand Central Station and New York and all these people will surely and certainly say there are only two labels. But the narrator of the story is telling ki that he will confidently say that there are three labels, one more label. Of Grand Central Station, yes, I have taken the obvious step. Because I have been on the third label of the Grand Central Station. He is saying confidently that there are one more label on Grand Central Station, dear students, because he has experienced, he reached third label. He has seen third label. He visited there. Due to that, he is saying confidently. And here is given, I have taken obvious step, clear step. Our writer is fully satisfied. Narrator. Or whenever he shared his experience to his psychiatrist friend, I talked to a psychiatrist friend of mine, among others, and when he told about the third label, what happened? What was his reaction? He said it was a waking dream to his fulfillment. It was a daydream. Understood? To make him satisfy. For his satisfaction, he has made such a story. He also gave his opinion. His psychiatrist friend Sam also told that the narrator, Mr. Charlie, was unhappy. Or due to he was unhappy, he was sad. Or that made his wife, a kind of mad. But he explained that he meant to, but and he wants to tell. His friend wants to tell him about his third label experience. Ki this world, as this world is full of insecurity, full of fear, full of war, full of anxiety and worry. Understood? So writer wants to just escape from all these things. Means his psychiatrist friend is not firstly believing about that story. In that, narrator tells that he has visited third label, he has seen third label, but instead of that, he is telling that he is just escaping from the reality, because this world is full of insecurity, full of sadness, full of full of worry, full of tension. So he does not want to face the reality, or he wants to escape from the harsh realities of life. Due to that, he has made the story of third label. This is the allegation of psychiatrist friend and explanation of psychiatrist friend sahib. Understood? But they don't wander down into any third level at Grand Central Station. They have never walked at Grand Central Station. But that is the reason he said, my friends all agreed. Or they also told him ki some people they used to do unusual thing because they want to escape from the harsh realities of life. His friend gives example ki narrator Mr. Charlie is fond of collecting stamps. This habit of collection of stamp is also a way to escape from the reality. Here is written, my stamp collecting, for example, that is temporary refuse from the reality. Dear students, well, maybe, but the writer here says ki his grandfather was also fond of collection of stamps. Why he was collecting? At that time the things were very proper. At that time there was no worry, no anxiety, no problem, no tension. So why he was collecting stamps? So allegation of his friend Mr. Sam was not true according to Mr. Charlie, because many people are fond of doing such things. Even dear students, ki that it is a nice collection too. Our blocks of four, practically every US issue first day covers. So the stamp collection, the stamp lovers, they used to collect such things, or they used to keep such big collection because they are fond of that. Even the President Roosevelt, he was also fond of collecting stamps. So narrator wants to give reply and explanation of that allegation which was imposed by Mr. Sam. If his grandfather was doing, if Mr. Roosevelt, the president of America, if he was doing such nice thing and collecting stamps, so they were not escaping from the reality. They were the good people. If they are imposing allegation on him ki due to escaping from the reality he is doing all these things, he is making story of third label, or he is doing collection of stamps, so why those people were doing? Why Roosevelt was doing? Why his grandfather was collecting stamps? At their time, at grandfather's time, Roosevelt times, the things were better. No problem, no worry, no tension, no fear, no insecurity. Why they were collecting? So their allegation was not true according to the narrator. Or he was not agreed to this allegation of his psychiatrist friend Mr. Sam, ki that there is no third label, or there is suppose only the way to escape from the reality, due to that he is doing all these things. Anyway, what happened? Ab narrator finally wants to tell ki that how he reached Grand Central Station. Up to this we discussed that what was the reaction of his साइकेट्रिस्ट फ्रेंड सैम अबाउट द थर्ड लेवल और व्हाट एलिगेशन ही हैज इम्पोज्ड, व्हाट एक्सप्लेनेशन ही हैज टोल्ड, बट द राइटर इज नॉट, नरेटर इज नॉट सेटिस्फाइड, मिस्टर चार्ली इज नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद दियर एलिगेशन. और फाइनली ही टेल्स दैट हाउ ही रीच टू द ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वॉट हैपेंड एट ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन वन नाइट, वन लास्ट नाइट आई वर्क लेट एट ऑफिस. और ही टेल्स दैट वंस वन लेट नाइट ही वॉज वर्किंग इन हिज ऑफिस एंड ही वॉन्टेड टू, वॉट ही वॉन्टेड टू, ही वॉन्टेड टू गो हिज होम. He wanted to go home. He wanted to catch the train because train took less time, or that bus takes more time. So he decided to catch subway train. Or when he reached that Grand Central Station, what happened? Here, I decided to take subway train, underground train from Grand Central Station because it is faster than bus. Now I don't know what happened, why this should happen to me. I just an ordinary guy, right? Narrator is telling ki he is a simple human being guy. He is ordinary guy, he is ordinary man. Up 31 years or he was wearing his suit and hat with fancy band or while going to the entering in central grand central station, he passed dozen of men looked like him. He was not trying at that time to escape from anything. He just wanted to, his intention was to reach home or to meet his wife, his wife lives, because he wanted to meet his wife. Because he worked late at his office or he was getting late, due to that he decided to catch subway train, underground train. Understood? I turned into the Grand Central Station from Vanderbilt Avenue, or he suppose got entry through that avenue, and he entered in that Grand Central Station, or he reached firstly to the first level where he could catch the train of 20th century. Then he went down another levels, he reached to the second level. So firstly he reached to the first level, then he reached to the second level. Or here is given where second level, where the suburban trains leave from. But dear students, he entered through a arched way. When he was going to the second level, he entered through a arched way, or that was heading to the subway, but at that time he lost. While going to catch that subway train, dear students, the narrator was lost. Or here is given, dear students, heading to, I have been in Grand Central Station, or many times he has visited Grand Central Station, but I am always bumping the new doorway stairs. But this time he was not getting his place, he was reaching to the new place. So how he suppose he was lost, or how he was going to the different places, how he reached to the lobby of Roosevelt Hotel once, how another times the 46th Street. Understood? All these things, dear students, I will teach you in the next video. Understood? So you have to read line by line, dear students. This is a very interesting story narrated by Mr. Charlie, or he is telling his experience that how he reached there. थैंक यू डियर स्टूडेंट्स।